four speakers. I will start and I'll give a review of some of the work that the coalition has done in the past. I will then hand the mic over to Dave McLaughlin, who is the Executive Director of Clean Ocean Access. He's going to highlight some of the work that's been going on the Quinnick Island side of our coalition. Amelia, who we all met on the bus tour, is going to review the work that's been going on in Providence and highlight the work with the job force work that Groundwork has been doing. And we're going to end with John Berard, who is the Director of Clean Water Action, Clean Water Fund here in Rhode Island. And he's going to talk about our work moving forward. I'd be remiss, and my husband would never forgive me if I didn't talk about logistics. The exit is behind you. The bathrooms are to the right. Feel free to get up and use the facilities if you need to during the program. And we also have asked to hold questions till the end. So after we have the speaking program, we'll have time for questions to the speakers. Coalition members all have stripes on their name tags. And after, we'll just take a couple of burning questions for the whole group. We have posters around the room that highlight the work of the coalition. Coalition members will spread themselves out around the room near these posters like we were doing earlier. And we hope you have time to stay and chat a bit with the coalition members and learn a little bit more about the work that's going on all around the state. So with that, I'll get started. The Green Infrastructure Coalition is working together to do what we saw on that tour, to create nature in our urban spaces, to bring green spaces into our urban spaces, to handle stormwater, but to also give us all those other benefits that green infrastructure provides. The dealing with flooding, the cooling, the quality of life, the social equality, and also the job training that we talked about with Groundwork, and Amelia will talk about it more. We are here to thank our funders, and the coalition came together in 2014 with support from the Rhode Island Foundation. The Rhode Island Foundation has been the driving force behind a number of coalition efforts that have formed here in the state of Rhode Island. We've found within the environmental community and the larger community that coalitions can really take an important issue, put some energy behind it, and move it forward. So we came together in 2014 at the request of the foundation to think about stormwater, and we picked this urban green infrastructure as our focus. And our goal is to reinvent our urban spaces with green infrastructure. We recognize and thank the state has great policies in place for incentivizing green infrastructure, low impact development for new development, but that isn't going to work when we're thinking about our urban spaces. There'll be some redevelopment, but we need other strategies to really bring the green into our urban spaces. This coalition is a big coalition, and it's a fabulous coalition. We have 30 members. I don't expect you to read them all, but they're on handouts and they're on our website. We have 30 partners in the coalition that include non-governmental organizations, and we work in the Providence metro area. The reason we picked those two geographies is because we're looking at green infrastructure as a tool for addressing stormwater, but also for those other co-benefits. And also to think about green infrastructure and what it can do in the world of, that we're experiencing with climate change. Now, on Quinnick Island, you've got stormwater runoff combined with sea rise and coastal flooding. There's a coastal flooding issue on the island. Here in the city and the surrounding communities, these are riverine communities where you've got the combination of riverine flooding and stormwater pollution. So we have two case studies by working in those two different places. In either place, we meet on a monthly basis, the coalition does. We meet 2 months in our separate geographies, so Newport meets and Providence, the Providence group meets, so we've divided our members geographically. But then quarterly, we come together as a large local level. Rhode Island has had enabling legislation for over a decade, allowing municipalities to create these dedicated funding streams, but so far, far, no municipality has gotten it all the way done. The coalition has been working with Middletown. Middletown has made progress, and Tom O'Loughlin is here. I can tell everybody more about it. He's right over here. Newport, just a couple of weeks ago, passed the council asked the staff to start exploring a stormwater utility structure for the city of Newport. Here in the Providence area, the Upper Narragansett Bay region, which is Providence, Pawtucket, Central Falls, East Providence, Cranston, and Warwick have been working now for a couple of years collaboratively. There wasn't enough to create a stormwater utility, which is a big challenge. They decided to do it regionally, which is a great idea and even more challenging. But Elizabeth Scott has been working hard, helping with the city of Providence and these other municipalities to lead that forward, and they finished their second phase of planning for that. There are other municipalities that the coalition is aware of and paying attention to. West Warwick is working on a stormwater utility. Westerly is talking about it. North Providence. So there's a lot of energy around stormwater utilities around the state now. The coalitions, we feel like if once one town really can get it done, get that dedicated funding for stormwater, the other towns will follow along fairly quickly. This is a lot of work being done. As a coalition, we also worked in the legislature to help get the $35 million green economy bond into the through the legislature, and will go before the voters in November. There are a whole lot of cities and towns that passed resolutions supporting that bond, and this is the first bond that has dedicated funding in there for stormwater and green infrastructure, $3 million. So we're excited to continue to work in the to build public support for that bond before the elections in November. The picture to the left, we see Greg Garrett giving a tour of the North Burial Ground. Greg has been encouraging us from the very beginning to start thinking about that connection between stormwater management, collecting water in our urban areas and managing it, and amphibian habitat. We have worldwide a crisis of amphibians, and he had observed the strength of the amphibian population in the stormwater swales and pools in the North Burial Ground. And based on that observation, has gotten policymakers and decision makers and scientists together to begin thinking, you know, what can we do about enhancing amphibian habitat in our urban areas as we're building our green infrastructure? And we're also working at the local level on local ordinances. An example of that is in Newport. They're considering a new parking lot ordinance. What can we do with that parking lot ordinance to encourage green infrastructure? Plans and projects from the very beginning have been a core part of what the coalition wanted to do. We knew that we needed to show people what green infrastructure is. We talk about it. I remember going to the legislature early on, and you talk about green infrastructure, you know, it sounds nice, but what is it exactly that you're talking about? We need to get out there and see these projects like we did in the tour. So we knew we needed to work on projects so that we could show them. And we also knew that putting green infrastructure, putting projects, installing projects in these urban areas was going to be challenging. And we needed to figure out what the challenges were, what were some of the obstacles, really get our hands dirty and learn about putting in these projects. And I think anybody who was on the tour got a sense for some of the partners that